Hey, Head Squeezers, I hope you're well. Really good question that's actually come in from a few different places this time. We've got Hayden Shayek, who posted this in our G Plus community, thanks very much. And also Mitcha Bibi Makawi in a YouTube comment in our Head Squeeze discussion page. Both posted a question which was, what are headaches and how do we get them? Very, very interesting one. And of course, they are the bane of so many people's lives. So I'm looking forward to unpacking this one. Should obviously say, Head Squeeze is not your doctor. So if you do get very serious headaches or regular headaches, then go see your local physician. However, if you are interested in the science of headaches, then you've come to the right place. So stick with us. Now, there are a whole range of different types of headaches, not just the type that my dad gets when he tries to write a text message on his archaic mobile phone. No, I'm gonna introduce you to tension headaches. That's the first kind, the dull ache that lots of us get quite regularly actually. And also vascular headaches. Those are the migraines and the cluster headaches of this world. And in my research, I found some people talking about cluster headaches and they say that they feel like having a red hot poker shoved in their eye. Nasty. So, why do we get them? First things first, the brain is not sensitive to pain. So you never get a headache from your brain. So if after a really long, hard day, I say, my brain really hurts, I'm kind of speaking a load of rubbish. You're allowed to tell me that. That's totally cool. So what's happening? Well, the pain has got to be around your brain somewhere. And there's loads of places that can come from. As I explained in my film all about ticklishness and actually why we get tickled, the skin is sensitive to pain, as are your bones and structures in your ears, your nose, your mouth, and it's there that the pain comes from. So what about a tension headache, that kind of dull ache that we all tend to get quite often? Well, that comes from holding your muscles in a semi-contracted state for quite a long period of time. That muscle tension that may come from the neck or the face or actually from the meninges, the tissues around your brain that help protect your brain. That muscle tension fires your pain receptors and that sends a signal to your brain's sensory cortex, and that's why you feel it as pain. Tension could come from emotional stress, it could come from poor eyesight or the wrong prescription. And what we normally do is we just take some paracetamol and that gets rid of it. Now, paracetamol is very interesting. It acts in the brain. It inhibits the pain and inflammation producing chemicals called prostaglandins. Now, the more intense headaches, the migraines of this world, they are called vascular headaches. Reason being, the main culprit of those are the large blood vessels. More specifically, it's a changed blood flow to the cerebral cortex. Science doesn't really know how or why they actually happen. One theory might be that there is a spasm in one of the cerebral arteries and that reduces the flow of blood and causes a localized lack of oxygen. Another idea is that maybe there is swelling in the blood vessels and that produces swelling, pushing on the nerves, and that produces the pain. Science isn't really sure just yet.
Excuse me, sorry.
Migraines can be set off by the weather, by bad diet, bad sleep, stress, and they tend to last between 4 and 72 hours. Interestingly, 1 in 5 migraine sufferers report having a visual disturbance, like a flash of light or zigzag lines in front of their vision before their migraine kicks in. Now, researchers think that the neurotransmitter serotonin must have something to do with migraines because the drugs used to treat migraines change the way that serotonin bonds to various receptors. Bad news, I'm afraid, for anyone watching who has 2 X chromosomes. Yes, women, you are more likely to get a migraine by a factor of 3 down to hormonal changes. Now, finally, cluster headaches. They are the really serious headaches that last for weeks, if not months. They are normally felt on one side of the head or around the eye. Not really sure what causes them, but scientists reckon it's again to do with the blood flow to the brain, and it may be kicked off by substances that affect that blood flow, like alcohol. I don't know if any of you have chugged tea and coffee during the day and then got what we can only call a caffeine headache once you've got home. the caffeine restricts the flow of blood to the brain. So as soon as you stop drinking it, you get a rush of blood. Oh, one more thing I want to mention is medication overuse headaches. These are headaches caused by taking pain medication for a really, really long amount of time. And a German study suggests it could now affect about 4% of the population. Again, they're not really sure why it actually causes these headaches, but they think it's maybe that pain medication for such a long period of time switches off the body's control system, the pain control system. Best way to get rid of it is just to go completely cold turkey. Right, bonus fact at the end, of course. 2,000 years ago, the people of the Western Han Dynasty treated their headaches with a chili-like fruit. Anyway, that's all the time I've got right now. Please do keep sending in your questions. We will answer one of them every Thursday here at Ask Head Squeeze. Put them in the comments down below these videos. Join our G Plus community and join in the discussion there. Until next time, happy head squeezing. Thank you.